Even if you believe Lord Birdbrook is taken care of, our ruse is not finished. I'm still in need of a husband.
Though I am flattered, I'm afraid I must reject your proposal.
Yes, I know. But we're not the marrying type. A million thoughts in my head. I thought you were leaving London.
I was. I am.
What did your father do to make you take that vow in the first place?
We do not need to have this conversation.
Do I not deserve an explanation as your wife?
You deserve more than that, indeed. I
can't decide what's wrong. She's taking you on a massive
tour. Hastings! The Duke of Hastings, now known for everyone.
Oh, the Duke of Hastings, is it?
It is simply surprising.
Yes, how ever is it possible for a lady to offer anything but a smile while seated beside a duke? So if I could be the only person left in the world, and yet somehow I'm not lonely. I'm comforted, at peace. And we must look like we are enjoying ourselves, as difficult as that may be.
Yes.
I do fear two dancers may leave our guests terribly unexcited.
I suppose the opposite, I would think. Maybe overly excited and terribly unruly. Two dancers at most.
Yes, that is what happens.
When one is angry.
When one burns for someone who does not feel the same.
You
deserve nothing less. You deserve everything your heart desires. I cannot provide it for you.
This is not just about finding the best match to impress Lady Whistledown. This is about a life. My life. You knew that becoming a mother one day, to have a family of my own one day, you knew that was all I ever wanted.
I was prepared to die on the
tomb. You may think you are too damaged and too broken to ever allow yourself to be happy, but you can choose differently, Simon. You can choose to love me as much as I love you. That should not be up to anyone else. That cannot be up to anyone else.
I do not believe there can be a more ridiculous notion than that of us ever being friends. And then Lady Bellia, her leaving strikes you.
She knows everything about everyone, even the Queen, and yet we have her utterly convinced that we are mad for each other.
We are awfully glamour.
Indeed we are. It is clear that you find there is nothing left in your marriage.
Nothing left.
You see, Your Majesty, it was love at first sight.
It was not, Your Majesty. The young lady flatters me. It was not love at first sight. Right, there was attraction, sir. At least on my part.
I only meant to say, I hope it did not pain you so much to see me with these children.
We found friendship. You see, Miss Bridgerton and I have been fooling all of Mayfair for quite some time. We simply enjoyed each other's company so much we could not stay away from one another.
If you do this, if we do this,